Really quickly, my game is modded, so a few of the decals and ads and signs and logos are from Blade Runner, and a couple of other things look different too. That's just because of mods, not anything else. Also, these mods didn't add any new locations into the map, and on the topic of map locations, I've been exploring a lot of them more recently. I played through the game twice before I even realized there's just a forest in the middle of the city. The map is enormous and there's a lot of stuff to find on the surface. And this was always a bit confusing to me. I mean, after all, Cyberpunk was supposed to be a vertical game, right? That's what they were saying before. Back when the map was revealed to be smaller than expected, they said it was because a lot of stuff happens in different floors of very tall mega buildings. But that doesn't really seem to be right. There's skyscrapers, but you only ever get to enter like three of them for some story quests. Obviously, Cyberpunk's map design changed while they were in the middle of building it, and some of you already know that means one thing, cut content. But let's not get ahead of ourselves here. Night City is still a very tall place. I've been to the tops of these buildings, and most of them aren't solid and aren't accessible, so instead of going straight to the top, we'll have to stay relatively lower, but still off the ground if we want to actually find anything. Of course, flying is impossible for the most part, more on that later, but I have a trick up my sleeve. Monorail lines. The first thing I thought coming out of the mega building V lives in was getting onto the monorail lines when I saw these trains darting past. There is an ultimately unused fast travel station that looks like it's a train station. It's not. So it wasn't really possible to get onto the tracks until I had double jump. And I don't even remember the insane parkour I had to go through to get up there from the mega building. I'll show you some better ways later on as well. But once I was on there, I just started running. First, I noticed that the sounds of the train will play as if one is running right on top of you, even if there isn't one there. So if one were to come up behind me, I wouldn't know if it was real or not. Of course, getting hit by one will either mean death or being violently thrown off the rail, and they're pretty hard to avoid. You'd probably need like 500 health and double jump. Needless to say, quick save a lot. I've been in the habit of doing that for a long time regardless, so no big deal. Every now and then I came across invisible barriers near these big support arches, and sometimes there was these fucking invisible angles over rails that shot me downward when I tried to walk on them, which doesn't usually end well. I had no way of crossing the tracks that had these angles over them, but usually it's just a barrier you can jump over. I used to think that there were two different trains, one that goes onto this thicker rail and one that goes onto the skinnier one, but these rails are actually connected with multiple trains running on them, so I wound up walking on the side of the fatter ones, which meant I didn't have to dodge trains. Anyways, after going through some pits of nothingness tucked away by buildings, I wound up at the city center. This is close to where all the corporations have their skyscrapers and those big fish fly through the sky, and I think this is one of the first places that CDPR built because it had some of that fabled cut content. I hate that word. I don't like that word at all. Content? If you say content, don't say content. The first thing I saw was this weird little strip on top of this building. It looked exactly like the stuff you'd see on the streets, but there was no way to access it unless you were on this rail. It has a Night City Center for Behavioral Health up there, which is just a building with plants and shit that lets you calm down, and what's nice is this one doesn't have people who will tell you to fuck off like the ones in the city. I don't know what to make of this location. I guess some of the places at higher altitude were going to function like streets, which would have been pretty cool. Down low there's a similar type of area that also functions like streets, but it's up just a couple stories from the ground. It's obviously not a finished area, some weird shit happens, but there's NPCs and it's accessible by stairs, so okay. Anyways, back on track, I found two different stations for the trains. The Night City Area Rapid Transport, or NCART, was probably intended to be a form of fast travel like the subways. This was mentioned during development and then confirmed to be scrapped, but there's still that accessible NCART place I mentioned near V's apartment. There's also subway stations that have fast travels in them, they both have fast travels in them, so it's pretty safe to assume these systems were kinda one and the same. What really convinced me here was that this station's doors weren't locked. Most of the doors you find around Night City can't be opened. Even ones in places totally out of reach are locked. Which likely means that when a door is placed in the world by a developer, it's locked by default. If that's the case, that means these doors were actually meant to function, and this station was, at one point in development, supposed to be accessible. Keep that in mind going forward, I'll circle back to that fact later on. Really, the only things worth noting that I found were around the city center and in Charter Hill. Around the city center, there was another station that wasn't solid when I tried to walk on it, and I fell through and died, and that was fun. There was some metal platforms that were likely there for some high-altitude combat interactions like you'd do normally, and you can even try to recreate them by getting police to spawn up there. Don't really recommend it. In Charter Hill, there's this building that lets you up to a mansion-like penthouse, and from there I got to another penthouse and saw that all sorts of rooftops in Charter Hill were open. Sometimes I ran into missing prefabs, which meant that there was some furniture sets there that probably got removed, some working vending machines, the other mansion had a flying car that didn't work, there's some doors. I think you were supposed to access some of these rooftops, but definitely not all of them. It's hard to tell, and I'd recommend you go and check it out for yourself, but I'm not so sure that you can. And that's the central point of this video. Initially, I just wanted to show my findings, but circumstances are different with Cyberpunk's new patch. I got to a couple of these locations without cheating. You can actually get onto these monorail rails and check out the city center's high places all you want. But getting around to other places, like the tops of skyscrapers and most places in Charter Hill, required the use of katana flying and also the immunity to fall damage, which just meant a lot of fucking health. Katana flying used to work by equipping and unequipping the katana at the same time, which made this happen, which let you do this. But that's been patched, probably alongside every other way that you could fly in this game. Cyberpunk's massive bug fixes took a long time to get here, and I wound up relying on a bug to do what's probably been my favorite activity in this game so far. Which sucks. This stuff was even doable on console without cheats if you weren't afraid of just using the one flying bug. Now I can't even find a way to do it on PC. Obviously, I'm not mad at CDPR for patching a bug in their own game, that's fine. Patch whatever you want. But I did notice they went back and locked the doors on the endcard station, which takes away from the story that this place tells, a place they know only curious people would find and want to learn from. If anything, I just want to show this stuff off in any way that I can now that it's so much more difficult to find, but if I could say one thing to CDPR, it'd be to either leave these places intact or expand them. Night City might just be my favorite location in any game just because I love exploring places that have, or at least used to have, a lot of attention to detail in places not everybody would reach. One of my least favorite things about video games today is there's really no incentive to go out and look for real secret achievements at least a month after release. Most people just Google it by then. But when it's something as trivial as an unlocked door, that's still something I probably couldn't just Google to find. I had to find that on my own. And for people watching this, there's still probably stuff out there that I haven't talked about. There is one easy way to get onto tracks without needing a lot of parkour. There's a Blade Runner reference in the form of a big hotel. It's located here on the map, and you can go inside and go up this elevator, and then climb up this stuff, and behind it is tracks that you can jump to, and just pick directions from there. Try not to get hit by trains, also, you can figure it out. Anyways, that's all from me, I'm out of here.